I knew I wanted to be a doctor when I was in sixth grade, and it was just a simple, I knew I wanted to help people, and I thought in my head, in my sixth grade mind, that being a doctor was the best way that I could help people.
That's the only really profession I ever considered since I was young, because actually my father's a physician. So, you know, growing up, you kind of just want to emulate and do everything that your father does. And occasionally he used to take me on rounds when he used to go to the hospital, and I used to tag along.
I knew early on that I wanted something that was going to be a fulfilling career, and I knew it was going to be one of the toughest things I would probably go through because of how academically grueling it's known to be. As soon as I walked in the door here at Drexel, I just immediately felt a really comforting feeling. The alumni, the students, everybody seemed happy. It didn't feel like, you know, this really uptight, nerve-wracking environment. It felt friendly. Once I had this interview and I got my acceptance, I didn't even go on the other interviews that I had. It felt like home as soon as I stepped in the door.
Over the past 4 years, we have seen a significant increase in the numbers of students who have received multiple admissions to many schools who choose to come to Drexel. In asking ourselves and asking the students, why do they choose Drexel over other medical schools? The answer is that we have a certain culture that they appreciate.
Although we're large in terms of size of seats, number of faculty, number of residents, there is sort of a hominess about this. There is sort of a community where people will say hello or hold the door, or, you know, the best part in terms of sort of a small town perspective that's here, and yet it's a big place. And there are other institutions across the country that I've visited that they're very big, they're very sterile, they're sort of very, you know, people are just kind of widgets. And I don't think that's here.
Before I came to medical school, I heard that it might be kind of cutthroat, and I heard that there might be people in school who might be out to get you. I've never experienced that in my life here, but more than that, I've seen people go out of their way to help other people. And I don't know why it just happens that that's how it is here, but it is.
We do a lot of team-based learning activities, and through those team-based learning activities, you really develop a good relationship with your classmates. It no longer really becomes a competition. It's, let's put our heads together and try and solve whatever problem we are presented with at that point in time.
Medical education is going away from one person standing in front of a group of people delivering a talk. It is my belief that technology-assisted education will help students become more highly engaged in the educational process. Simulation has become one of the most important technologies in the acquisition of knowledge for health professionals.
What it does, it gives the opportunity for our students to get the hands-on experience. You know, lots of times we just read about how to intubate a patient in books, but you don't really know what it's like to do it in real life. But when you're in the sim center and you're actually trying to do things to correct that, it just makes everything worthwhile.
It is so cool. There is a simulated person that speaks, that sweats, that will respond to things like a patient would, and it reinforces the importance of memorizing the minutiae that we do learn, because when you're in that room and you have to pick that drug that is not gonna kill your patient, you feel the pressure. And if you pick the wrong drug, you see that line go flat. And that can't happen in real life. So it really, once again, it helps enforce why you're here and why you're doing what you're doing.
The students are simply inspiring. They're interested not only in their studies, but they are truly committed to understand medicine in the context of the society in which it takes place. Many of our students volunteer in free clinics. They mentor children who may have aspirations to become health professionals. They do a variety of activities that really reflect their love for their profession and their very strong vocation.
First year, Drexel actually does have a mandatory requirement that all students participate in some type of community service project. The program that I did was called Drexel Mentoring Pipeline. It gives students the opportunity to be exposed to the sciences and healthcare and gives them an avenue to see what it's really about. You know, not just saying you come be a doctor, but you can be a nurse, you can be a phlebotomist, or any type of healthcare aspect at all. So what we do is we give them tutoring, we give them the opportunity to come to the school and see different things such as the anatomy lab, how to use the microscopes and things of that nature. It's something about being able to reach back and put a smile on kids' face.
When I get to go out into to our shelter or do any type of community service through Drexel, I remember why I want to be a doctor. And it is really hard for a lot of people to convince themselves to go into medicine knowing that they're going to have, you know, a lot of loans coming out of school, and it's a very competitive process, and there's a lot of work and time that goes into becoming a doctor. It's more of a calling, and it takes over your life. It's a big deal. So any person that can help to continue that, I just want to say thank you to them.
If I could talk to a Drexel donor, I would definitely like to say from the bottom of my heart, I truly thank you for the donation that you have given to Drexel. It has really helped to enrich my education here. And it really just shows that somebody understands what you are going through and is willing to do something to help you and reward you for your work. It really means a whole lot.